right, ladies and gentlemen, today on The Average Garage, I'm going to be showing you how to re-spool a Dyneema rope onto a winch. Now, this is a very important thing to do if you have just replaced your Dyneema rope or you are replacing your steel cable even. You need to make sure it's spooled on correctly to avoid what you can see now, which is the Dyneema rope curling under itself because it's being pulled through rope that isn't tensioned properly. So I re-spooled this a while ago when I rebuilt the winch, and I never actually used the winch since. I've been meaning to re-spool it ever since, but it bit me in the ass the other week because I hadn't re-spooled it and it pulled through itself. So to start off, you want to make sure you have one full drum length of Dyneema rope around the drum, so at least one complete roll from end to end. This takes the load so it doesn't put all of the pulling force of the rope on the pin itself or the grub screw or the bolt or whatever is holding the rope into the drum. The main thing is here, when you are re-spooling your winch, you want to have constant load on that rope. So as you can see, I'm putting a hook through my spare tire and then wrapping it around a log, just a simple way so it pulls on the wheel, and I'm not using the actual hook on the wheel itself, just purely for the fact that I didn't want to damage the wheel. You can also hook your car up to a pole or a tree and drag your car to the pole or tree under the power of the winch. But the only problem with that is it gets quite hard to steer the rope while you're pulling the tension of the car. So as you can see, I'm feeding the rope in on a side-to-side basis, so like a zigzag on the winch, and you want to make sure the rope is close together to itself until it hits one end of the drum, and then feed it back in the other direction. Now usually you'd give your winch a break every now and again, but this is a low load scenario. It is still load though, so I gave myself a 30-second break here just to cool the winch down a little bit, and then back to spooling it back. So the tire is acting as a load just to put some tension on that rope. Once the tire or whatever you're pulling towards your car is close enough to the car, you can actually remove it from whatever your load device is, be it tire, stick, log, rock, whatever, and then pull the rest in just with you holding onto the winch. So you'll see in a second, once I remove the tire, I actually hold the hook and drag myself towards the car, and then you can hook it up to your rebar or wherever you want to have the hook, on a recovery point or tow point or wherever. So that is the correct way to spool a winch, so you have constant tension on the rope so it doesn't do what mine did and pull through itself. So if this video has helped you in any way, shape or form, please hit the like button, hit the subscribe button and the bell button after that to stay up to date with all new videos for tips, tricks and other things. Hope you all have a good one and hope you all enjoyed. See you in the next video. Cheers guys, peace out.